your fish, your food, and everything included. Being means everything for us. As a matter of fact, it is what we call I vary my diet or whatsoever. You eat that maybe with Gary in the morning or in the noon, and then in the afternoon you put the war into it, that make another story. But that's how it was. But when people say that sometimes African people are poor, I might just simply tell them they are wrong, because even though these people look poor, they are happy every single day. That's my pride. I'm sure it's the pride of somebody too. Cassava is another story. Gary and everybody else, the tapioca, everything you do in my country or in Togo. I come from the city where the starch factory has been built back in 1953. And that's the only place you can have a machine proceed with the cassava and give you the tapioca. But most of the time, we couldn't even eat that in our country. And if you do, maybe when the truck is passing, some follow from the truck, and then you are lucky you get it. But what is processed in our factory, we usually don't have it because it's all exported. But our mothers, they are our champion again. They will make it with hand, and it's even better than what the machine used to do. But it's a hard work. Like you can see, this lady here, right here, I can even sing a song about how they used to do that. Jean, as they proceed like this, because I've done it so many times myself. Your fingers, you will lose portion of your skin, but that's the only condition you can get the gary done. If you can't, then your children will struggle, no food. There's even a time when we don't have food that we call kankinkan. Because you eat the gari as a pack paste, and you eat that differently. Maybe you just pour water into it. Sometimes we call it pousser d'achemin. But really, those are the moments that I think about. And that's maybe one of the reasons why I choose to be with Uganda Center to support students. Because anyway, if we didn't pass away, then this student today should also be given a chance. So, I talked a little bit about Togo now. Let's talk about Brad. That was me in my sugarcane plantation. That's the beginning of my journey to the US, by the way. As I was growing my sugarcane, I should tell you that it was my first year to go to high school. And due to lack of financial support, I had to give up. I gave up for 1 year. I went back to that field. I'm sure if you go back to where I worked, I don't know what happened. The field that I used, by myself only, 5 people went after to do the same work. They couldn't do it because they don't have that motivation. I was crazy enough to work even when there's no electricity, up to 11 p.m. using lantern. You don't have even electricity. That's how I plug this thing up. That line you have, I have people who are older than me, if I remember, but so many names, by the way. When they open up a line, they are not able to close it by the end of the day, but I can close up these 2. People who were older than me, they couldn't close up that thing that you see, the mound that you see, they couldn't, because I say, whatever happened, I need to get that money, and the next year I need to be in school. So I can't give myself any excuse to say I'm not gonna do it, because I know if I don't, nobody is going to give it for me for free. I must do it by myself. But it's not the end of the story yet. When I was growing there, I discovered that there's a black insect. They are just enjoying the root of my sugar cane. When I go home, they'll eat it up, and then my sugar cane will just fall. I said, really? But as even my colleague, agricultural engineers here at the time, we don't have any extension service available to provide you support, that you can even get a call in your county, you have extension agent. We don't have any. I said, really? But if I recall correctly, the money I earned from that field could have bought even more than 10 lots of terrain or land in Togo today. That was the first time I enjoyed getting more money in my pocket, even though I was really poor. So after that experience, I said, I'm gonna do a little bit more. So I enjoyed this transition, but because I couldn't solve the insect issue, I said, well, if nobody can fix it for me, then I must do something about it and get a solution by myself. But what can I do? That's the time I asked people around and said, the only way you could do it is become agricultural engineer. I jumped on the boat as I was doing that one to get my degree. And if I back up just a second, before I get the money I just mentioned, they are my champions. Again, that's the third time I mentioned ladies here. She came, I remember that time I received 1,000 CFA from her. I gave her only 10 sugar cane, whatever you want to call it. But what you see there, I just cut 10, but I have billion. So you can just estimate how much I can make just with my sugar cane. And when you're getting the money, it's very easy, but to get it to where you sit is not easy. As a high school student, these are my employees who are working for me. I pay them, they enjoy food, everything. So I know how to live even from my very, very hard time. I get people to work with me together. We all earn money together. We enjoy life in that village. I can point to you their name without even look at the picture because we did struggle together. So that's one way I was earning money. My second meal is this. Look at me very carefully here. I was just a little boy at the time I mentioned, and look at the time too. It is because I don't have food enough, I don't eat the way I'm supposed to. I was a little bit skinny, but it doesn't mean that I wasn't strong enough to do work that people who are stronger than me or bigger than me could do. But at the time, motor taxi, I was the thief there. Because I was the only guy who can speak French clearly. All the people that you see, they couldn't. So we went to the prefect in Aneho who were in the process to ban motor taxi. And I told them, you have your children going to school. And I gave up. And I'm doing this to earn money in order to continue my study. And you dare to ban this activity. Then you're going to give them the money. If you don't, you're going to let me do it. You all know if you can speak to a prefect at my age, I'm sure you can, but given my condition, I have to open my mouth. So he said, sir, what do you want now? I said, give me your permission to organize something. So I asked for the first time in my village in Afuan, people have to wear blue shirt with the number. And my elders asked me, what number do you want us to write on your t-shirt? I said, because I'm a little, I choose to have it as just number 8. So I got the number 8, that's how I go by at the time. So my name was number 8, just to end this story. 2 years later, I'm not going to mention the name of somebody here, but his sister here, he started something that he couldn't finish at. It is for a student of Afuan that I built up on, and I launched officially the association back in that time. And again, you will see how thin I was. I'm that guy here, I'm the teacher. And most of the students you see today, they are working. They are even richer than me. When I go back home, they just, my phone won't even stop ringing. We're ready whenever you are. We're gonna host you here. We're gonna do this for you. We're gonna do this for you. To me, my existence, even if I pass away today, I do believe that I'm going to continue living because these people are living through our struggle, our effort that we have been able to do. And after my study at the University of Lomé, the same place that so many people have been to, I was lucky that when the kind of gave the result, I was the first. When you are first, you don't choose where you should go. The university will send you to IITA. So I was in Parliament. By the way, that was the place I was there doing my research and I found my wife. Even though I was looking for a job, I also get a wife there. So that's a double mission, by the way. I'm grateful that this turns out to be a good business. But I got this position because I was excellent. Not because I deserve it, maybe it was lucky, but maybe it's in the plan of God. I just praise him for what he does for me. So I got that assistantship. I point to them because I can't forget the day. That's the day I signed my contract. I got to study the training chief of it. If you see this name of Skerat, by the way, is Chinese Chefabindo. Hold on tight because I'm going to show you some pictures and then you can relate to that name. So we got that done, but in the process of studying the diversity of host plant and the Quetzalcoatl mining, something happened. How can I identify the insect that I want to study? There's no resources again available in Africa to do so. The only people on earth who I used to do what I was doing, they are in the US, but I'm gonna continue elaborating on that a little bit. There's one is Jameson Lees. I say it's gonna be one day I will have to meet that lady in my life. But it happened already in 2012 because that's done in the plan of God, that everything comes in the right time. So, as I was telling you, these are the Chinese Chefabindo. The first mention of this name was in Cameroon during German time when they were colonizing the country. And this was the first time I got it in our country. By the way, for both, it was the first time that I got the hand on it and put a name to it. It wasn't done until I did. This also, I'm sure everybody here knows that they are Japanese people. And their Chinese name is Poppy. Looking beautiful. But we have many, but I choose to pick up those few. This one, if I close my eyes, it's Paramelas Ecclesiata. Those names, I can pronounce them like I'm talking. It will be very difficult for you to do it because that's my job, that's how I get money. So, this gentleman here is called Anomala Georgi. And by the way, Georgi is the name of my boss. He is the one who paid for everything. So, because it's a new species for the science discovered for the first time, he chose to just use his family name and add just I to it and make his name eternal. That's how he referred to himself when we were presenting the result. He said, Brad, you know, one thing I do like about you, you don't give up, even though that I squeezed him, you showed me that you have the determination to finish your project. But by the way, I'm so proud of what you did, that's what he said. I will always remember that date of December 15, 2005. Same year that we got this. But it's not something that is easy as I said. I was sitting in my office for nearly 2 years, simply because there's no airstrip in Togo or in West Africa. It has to be shipped to Belgium. And the gentleman who identified this has to use resources of back to 1700. You can just count how many hundreds of years books that you have to navigate through before getting hold on to this thing. It took him nearly 2 years. But my other colleagues, they spent nearly 6 to 9 months to finish up their master research and defense. For me, I have to spend 2 ridiculous. Excuse me for a term, but I gotta use it. Because it's new, for the science everybody knows when you discover something, it's becoming more interesting. Say, I need to know how this is done. And I put myself into trouble because there's nobody in Togo who could train me to become insect taxonomist. But with that struggle, waiting to get a colleague to train me, there's one day that I only had $2 in France Air Class, please. One colleague of mine called me, hey, brother, I need to scan X, Y, and Z, send this, but that time we don't have access to the internet, you have a smartwatch, so you have to go from one point to the other, you go to that cyber cafe, blah, 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 but you wouldn't get it to work. So I called the gentleman, is that okay if we come to your office to do it? He said, yes, we could do it. So I used the meal phone that I have to pay for gas into the motor bike that doesn't even belong to me, is for my elder brother that I borrow so that I can help my colleague. I got that guy, we couldn't eat that day, I remember, but at the end of the day, when we came, I saw him at the cousin calling for technical coordinator for Peace Corps program. And the profile, the way they described it, I was very confident that there's no mistake in this. In my country, I believe it's going to be one and only one person for one reason. In Botany, for instance, I was the top. Nobody could have beaten me up. And I was crazy confident and I took turned my attention. I was waiting, I was still in the same motorcycle, and I remember Miss Priscilla called me. I was close to College St. Joe. She said, "Are you Mr. Humpati?" I said, "Yes." She was speaking in English that I didn't understand, but I remember one thing. I answered yes, yes, yes to all the questions and comments that she had to go through. She said, "Do you accept the job?" I said, "Please don't ask me that question right now. I just need that job now." And I got the job. We were talking through this one. This gentleman here is Mr. Agree. He is like my father. He has been the coordinator before I came into power. But he said, "You are just stupid. You can't even sleep. You get the work done before I will even wake up. So I just let you do the job and then I will relax." As you can see, he is taking notes when his assistant is speaking. I can't even claim that I'm smart. It just came as I opened my mouth. So one clip. And that gentleman you see over there is David Johnston. To appreciate what I was able to do, he chose to serve in my village generally. He spent pretty much 3 years fixing problems that I could have solved, and he did it so well. And I'm proud of this gentleman. So he was in salary close to Mango with the sisters of the monastery. And that's the only place you can get those things done. So to do it quick, from that story, as I was telling people, I need to do this, the service in the US only you could do that. They referred me to something at the time, really, called Fulbright. They said, "Really, Fulbright? What is that?" They say you get a scholarship and then you go to US. What you want to do is, no. I don't speak English. I can't go to that country, please. They say, "Can you just try?" So one time I decided to do so I did try. I was just not expecting that. And they said, "Sir, we believe that you can do this." Really? So they put me into it. I got it. They say, "You go to the University of Georgia." I say, "Who? Is it going to be the city of the border?" So I came into it. I'm going to be a little bit faster here because I'm running out of time. So I got a scholarship in. I came into it because I know I've served in Peace Corps for 7 years. So I was like, I know America so well. But two of my fellows couldn't even understand lease. If you want to rent a room, the guy was told the room is $1,100. It is 4-bedroom apartment. So to him, is $1,100 speaking to four. So there's no question about it. Let's sign it. He did sign it. He came into it. He's in trouble. His stipend is $1,500. So he paid $1,100 of it. He doesn't have a kitchen. And so he was struggling until he came back. "I'm just throwing what I'm eating in that student room. I couldn't. I'm just going to go home." And then he was crying, "Hold on a second. Let's try this." I called the office, even legally, I wasn't bound to the contract. I said, "Hey, you, here's my take for you. This guy needs a kitchen. You don't have one in the room. That's one issue. Second, you're giving him food that he's not used to. Third, he's not going to school. And last thing that is going to happen is going to fail. But one thing I can guarantee you, in his comment, he will tell you that if you didn't understand X, Y, and Z, he's going to put the blame on your university. Do you want that fail to be on your university? If you choose to do so, that's going to be your business. But if you want, cancel that contract right now and free the guy." So I said that. I didn't even know what I was saying. But the lady called me just a few minutes after I hang up and said, "Sir, I think you are right. We can find a way to cancel this contract with no penalty. And then he can go and do his stuff." Same thing happened in New York. I did it in the same way. So I report back to the U.S. Embassy that, "You know, I didn't know this, but I tried something that is working. I think I'm going to do it." So at the time they decide, everybody come in now, you're going to be their godfather, their advisor, so that you walk them through every single piece to make their transition easy. So as I was doing that, they come in, we became friends, they're serving me. But for my project, those ladybugs that I studied, I almost travel around the world, by the way, for it. I call them my boss. Insects are so powerful. If you are still student and you're thinking about getting a job, you can jump in my boat. You're going to love it because they will make you travel around the world. Because that's true. I can't lie to you. That's how it is. So as I helped them, I told them on the way coming, "Would you be willing to bring some of those stupid, crazy stuff to me?" They say yes. So they will be bringing them. So each time he said 1,500. Each time he said 1,500. 1500 for 9 times. He said, wow, I think we got an investment that we need to invest into something. So one day, I asked them, what can we do? I told them about this late senator who created the Fulbright Scholarship. I told them that it might be something like that that happened to him to create the program. Can we do something? With due respect, they say, grand frère, which means big brother, propose something, we're gonna follow you. These are the four you just read about. These are the four we talked about all the time. So I send them the next day something in 2 pages, and I call the program Bourse Grain de Sel. Scholarship named Grain of Salt, because just a little pinch in the meal, it is so delicious. For a student struggling, it's just a little bit of that grain. Everything is solved. So we got that program in. We get it incorporated and get everything. Just the same way we called for application X, Y, and Z. We were five. We were very passionate about it. We want to do it, so we move forward. And that's the time we call joy into it. When you see students come like that, I always call for a meeting. Welcome meeting. So we talk about how you're going to survive in the U.S. And that's how I perceive all these people have contributed, the same way I do. Grain de Sel, I'll just explain how it is. We don't have enough money, just a little bit, but we are happy that we can give that up to help other people. That's what the name is. So to make it faster, I'm going to move up again. We incorporated in Georgia. We got national office established in Togo, and then we call for application first, second, and we go on. Pretty much, this is what Mr. George put me, and he himself is here, and this is our board. That's pretty much how we function. There are so many people who are working. If you refer to Grain de Sel as Brad, I'm just going to tell you that it is not true. It is all these people working. I'm just serving, helping, facilitating. That's what I do. But where is our office? It's online. We don't have any office that you locally that you're gonna find. It is online. Everything runs the same way. This machine is our server. That's the reason why it couldn't connect, because my location, it couldn't have been verified. Even when I want to log in, I have to go through so many security crises to quick questions. So it's true, everything that we will have to do today. But we got that money collected, send it back to Togo. Money spent according to the law, US law and Togo law, report came into it, so we know what we do with the money. So the team was 7, but we moved up to 12 to have our former grantees to be serving now on board, so that we transition from us to them, so that we know our program is going to be sustainable. That's one key of it. They are all volunteering. As we were doing this, a professor at the university will be advisor for the grantee. Make sure that everything is done. You have to perform at least 85% of all your courses done by the end of the semester. If not, we're gonna just take away money. If you wanna keep it, you have to work hard for it, because that's what we want. So far, 25 grants from the beginning. And we currently have 3 students in France. One is about to graduate in Burkina Faso, and one was in Bulgaria, but he came in, and he's now in France. At the University of Kara, Ms. Tawa, can you come up a little bit here? Please, you have to. Even if we run late, please allow me to mention this. This lady has done something that I need people to know about. And when she joined the board, I told her that your job is going to take care of the ladies. Hey, come close to me, please. Come on. So she had a lady, what is the name of the lady you have been advisor for? She did something that I wasn't able to do, and I want to tell people how it did. She pushed the student all the way, and she has been the first at the University of Kara. As I'm speaking right now, everything that's going to be done at the University of Kara, she made that body to be the spokeswoman of the university. Every time there's something, she's going to be the one who will speak. I'm sure you're proud of what you did. But please, before I let her go, I want a big round of applause for her. Thank you so much. And that was the one that I have too, is very successful. He's now in France. People call him Brad's son. I told him, if you want to work with me, I like the first rank. You're going to be first if you don't even just call me, because I struggle to be first. If you have any money from me, you must be. If you do, I promise you one thing. You're going to travel, you're going to love, because you're going to run through scholarship all the time. He's now studying at the University of Paris, free of charge, please. If you have been able to do that in your time when you're in Togo, please tell me. So, we organize career workshop. Why? If you are here, if you have applied for a job in Togo, you know how hard it is. I remember, for me to get my first job, I have applied for more than 150 times. I will repeat. I have applied for more than 150 times before I got my first job. Even the letter you have to write is a challenge. The resume, how I have to present it, is a challenge. Everything, we love to share that package of experience so that the student that we pay for are job, career ready, and very competitive. That's why we organize those training for them so that they are able to do stuff. Just the same way, we invite all Fulbright scholars, number one, to share their experience in the US. Number two, encourage people to speak English in addition to French. Plus, more than 50 local languages is very challenging. But that's the only way, even though my English is the worst you have ever heard, I'm sure you understand what I'm saying, right? That's just the key, good enough. So, as we did that, if I tell you that until today I don't have my birth certificate, would you believe me? But truth being told, I don't. I found my birth certificate only when I was about to finish my university degree. I know what can happen, because if you don't have the citizenship, you can't go to the university, you could be a smarter person, you won't be able to make it. So we put forward for the student to go up front, to encourage people at the high school to start the citizenship part on time, so that they can have the card identity, which is national ID card, on time, so that they won't miss the opportunity. So far, they've done it. And one thing they did, they were surprising, they went to my village as an honor to me to talk to people over there. Because I love people in Ghana, they went over there too. So we have been able to sponsor a few people to get it, which was a good experience. But you see how many people your money is doing, that's the at Lycée d'Enfoine. And here is at the Awandero in Ghana. We didn't do this, it's our grantees who organized this. And we believe that having a community project is a way to sell at a very high price our students. So we push them to have a community project so that they go across before the authorities and people work hard, so they are already known even before they graduate, so that if they are applying for any job in their field, they saw everything in already, they just have to have it. It's gonna be easy. And as of now, they are able to go to the president of the university. If you have studied in Togo, could you raise your hand just for me at the University of Lomé, just very quick? Have you been able to go to the office of the president of the university one time in your life?
No.
Could you even think about it? But because with US, we have learned how to talk. We have learned how to organize everything. We taught the student to ask for audience and talk to the president and talk to the top leader so that they can speak their voice about what they think that they need so that they get the support. If it is not working, we're gonna jump into it and make sure that what they're looking for is done. As of the last meeting, they met with the director of the DBS, which is the Office of Scholarship. You all would think that I was crazy when I was proposing people to do this. But I can't tell you how crazy and happy and proud I am of these people. Because my team, trust me, they put the confidence in me that just try whatever comes to your mind, provide this work and help the community and the student. I mentioned what Tawa did. This is Valerie when we recruited her under our program. But this is the same Valerie today. You will see the smile is coming up because she has to smile. Things has changed, huh? And this is the president of the University of Ghana. I think in our country, many people will agree with me, he's the humblest person. that I ever know. Even though he's the president, look at how he's looking before the student. He bowed his head, right? That's the same way that guy did to me. He gave me his administration at the university, even though I was just a master degree student, finished. He said, do whatever you think is right in my office, fix stuff. If I know about administration today, it is because Professor Sander is willing to change our life for good, and he did. So, among the students I picked to talk about, one single person who now is an entrepreneur. I'm gonna go a little bit deeper. Please let me know how many times I have people. Because this guy, when I went to Lomé in 2015, he approached me, Brad, you know, my mother, my father, my whatever, that I'm gonna be whatever, say, hey, what do you mean? What are you creating so many limits yourself? Did your God tell you that you have that limit? Or who is telling you that you are limited? I told him, I think I already cleared it. Impossible is just a word. It doesn't exist. You have to push it away. So he said, I got that. But how can I change those limits? I said, just make it like this. One step at a time, and second, and you keep moving, you just keep moving, you're gonna make it work. He called me a few months later, brother, I think I got it right. I'm going to become an entrepreneur. What are you gonna do? He sent me a proposal. I don't remember if I sent it to you, but I sent it to the whole team. By the time maybe you didn't join us yet. So everybody review what he wants to do with the experience and everything. So he just tried. So the government gave him more than 4 million. Have you ever received that? I only received $20,000. That's the max that I received. So he launched his business. He has people working for him now. The guy was just a little boy, but you see, I don't even get dressed like that because I don't have that money, right? He's a businessman, he has to look good. The same person, he said when he was going to Dakar, getting into the flight was the first time, he said, Mr. Brad, what did you think about me when you were telling me all this crap? I'm about to fly for the first time anyway. Thank you so much. For us, being in a flight for the first time is an accomplishment. So it was the flyer he sent me 3 days ago. There's a lot of stuff, and this is the powerful person in Togo, Mrs. Sidelman, right here. She's the head of the cabinet of the president. I swear I can never invite that lady to come to any of my meetings. But our guy, he learned how to talk and get things working. And he's smiling at Mrs. Sidelman. Oh, I guarantee any Togolese that can prove me wrong, come forward and tell me that you can invite that lady to come to any of the media meetings, the best. She is not going just to come because it won't happen. But this guy is making it work, right? And one thing is the smile.